Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of Canzida, the Candida dietary supplements of choice. Thanks for tuning into my video. We're going to talk about probiotics again today. What makes them thrive? What really encourages probiotics to grow really well? Some people love gardening. I'm one of those people who loves to garden. It's interesting when I get friends over and they have a look at the vegetable garden and the flower garden. They say, wow, you guys are lucky you can grow these things. And we can't grow anything, you know. Every time I plant something in the garden, it dies, you know, and it goes all brown and it just doesn't look good. And basically the difference is the person who loves gardening is going to water the garden, maintain it, give it food, make sure it's got the right environment. And the vegetables flourish, they take off. And then you get the other gardener who will put something in the ground, water it once, and then not look at it again. And that's called neglect. And then they turn around and say, well, I haven't got a green thumb. Well, you can see the difference between the two people. Probiotics can really thrive in a person's digestive system, particularly if the person allows a probiotic to have the right kind of an environment that's conducive towards its well-being. Just like that broccoli plant is in the vegetable garden, or those bell peppers that you're growing, you know, they've got certain types of requirements. If you look after the needs of something that's living and growing, you can either make it thrive, or you can make it, you know, you can maintain it, or you can neglect it and let it die. So it's really your call. So the best way to make probiotics thrive is to make sure that implantation occurs. So just like our fetus has to implant into the wall of the endometrium in a woman before it can grow and really flourish as a baby, beneficial bacteria have to implant themselves into the wall of the digestive system. They don't just float around like in a whole big bowl of pea soup or something, just floating around, you know. It doesn't work like that. They actually have to attach themselves onto a wall, a surface, and then grow colonies off those. And that's what we call implantation. It's very similar to what happens with biofilms. So biofilms, I'm going to talk about on other videos. Biofilms occur in about 4 or 5 stages, just like how beneficial bacteria really take off. You know, you get a first a few bacteria in one particular area that will find an area quite suitable and move in, but it's not until more and more come along that the colonies can become established and they can get a firm foothold in that area where they're trying to implant. When more and more come along, and particularly the foods for those beneficial bacteria come along, and the pH, you know, the acid alkaline environment is good, the colonies will grow faster. Implantation takes more of a foothold. And before you know it, a very small town's developed of, say, you know, several hundred bacteria. And then if the conditions are even more conducive, the person's eating the right kind of food, and there's enough enzyme power there to break that food down into small components to give these bacteria food, then the colonies will grow even faster. And before you know it, you've got a mini city on your hands. Same with biofilms. You can have an environment that's really hostile for beneficial bacteria and very conducive for these bad buggers, drinking lots of booze and pizzas, eating at weird times and having a high stress diet. These are the things that contribute a lot, you know, particularly if you're starting to take antibiotics and different kind of medications, skipping meals, having lots of sugar in your coffee, lots of chocolate bars or lots of candy bars, and junk food all the time. Then before you know it, your digestive system is more like a minefield. You know, it's toxic, it's a terrible environment. And because it's going to be conducive towards candida, you're going to get the bloating and gas to go with it. So it doesn't take a rocket scientist to work out the opposite of good is bad. So having the good digestive system, plenty of beneficial bacteria, eating the right kind of food, making sure implantation, you know, occurs and then is maintained for a long period of time. Some people think they can take probiotics for 2 weeks and stop and then it's all good. Well, it doesn't work like that. You've got to take probiotics for months. Trust me, I've worked with patients for a long time. You need to work with probiotics with someone sometimes for 3 to 6 months, even 12 months. If you want very successful implantation, you do that. If you want a beautiful vegetable garden, you make sure you go out there regularly and you till the soil. You put, you know, good fertilizer, compost in there, whatever fertilizer you use. Keep replacing the plants all the time when they die out, you know. Make sure they're getting adequate rainfall and things like that. If you look after the garden, it's going to look beautiful. And it's the same with your gut, you know. Taking probiotics for a long period of time makes a lot of sense. because you'll get good implantation. And once you've got a strong foothold with millions and, you know, billions of beneficial bacteria, think about the quantity of lactobacillus and bifidobacteria in the intestine. They make up between 30 to 50% of the whole bacterial tract. So it pays for you to take a supplement containing lots of lactobacillus and lots of bifidobacteria. Check out Candida Restore. I made it for that reason. I made a supremely high quality product that you need to take in small amounts long term to get fantastic effects. And I put the enzymes with it, because a good probiotic needs a really good enzyme blend. That's going to allow you to break down the food properly that you eat, and to give the bacteria further downstream in the GI tract lots and lots of good food to eat, so you'll feel better faster. Thanks for tuning in.